Back in the day when I was taking a lot of meditation classes and going to workshops every weekend and really diving deep into the spiritual world, I would many times get asked, so what's your spiritual practice? Do you have a spiritual practice? And you know, 9 times out of 10, I just was like, I think it's sleep. I think that sleep is my spiritual practice, because what I have found is that when I prioritize sleep, I am more tuned into my intuition. My ideas are better. I get more done in less time. I'm not cranky. I'm actually pretty happy and joyful, because there's a whole host of things that go on scientifically inside our bodies when we sleep enough, such as hormone regulation. Our cortisol levels go down. We don't have that sense of fight or flight. We're able to be more in our parasympathetic instead of our sympathetic nervous system, which is the rest and restore nervous system, and life just generally feels better. So we have this culture where it's this idea of like pushing harder and doing more is actually celebrated. And oftentimes people talk about how little they've slept but have managed to keep going as this badge of honor. It's really problematic, because I don't know if you're familiar with Arianna Huffington's work and her sleep revolution, but there's so much data around when we don't sleep, how much our physical health suffers, how much our productivity suffers, how much our creativity suffers, our relationships suffer, and it's really, really a problem. Now, many times I might have believed that the less I slept, the more I got done. But it's actually the opposite. I have found that the more I sleep, the more I get done, because the times that I'm actually awake and working, I'm so much more effective. Now, from the spiritual perspective, I am more tuned in. When I'm exhausted and sleep deprived, which I've had many experiences of this because I have 2 small children. So I'm, you know, listen, if you have small kids, I totally get it. Like, sometimes it's just not within your control. And I stand with you in solidarity around that. And you may have other reasons you're not getting sleep, whether it's health issues or whatever. However, when I'm able to, I do get as much sleep as possible, because what I found is I don't know, my... Now I'm about to be very woo-woo. My channels are more open when I sleep. I have better dreams. I'm not up in the night. I do this weird thing when I'm sleep deprived. I wake up in the night and have these weird visions and anxiety dreams. And my husband's always like, do you remember talking to me in the middle of the night and like screaming? I'm like, no, I don't. But it's a problem. And so when we sleep enough, we are able to be more in tune with ourselves. We're able to listen to other human beings better. And we're able to, I believe, be more in tune with God, with spirit, with the divine, with the universe, whatever you call it, to be able to listen in, to know what's the highest and best use of our time and how we can really be more on purpose and be more in joy in the world. So I invite you to sleep. That's what I'm saying here. Prioritize sleep. Do what you need to do to get to bed. Cancel your plans, stay home, get in bed, because your life will be better if you're well rested. Everything will be better if you're well rested. I proudly say that I try to be in bed by 9. I do. I try to sleep like 8 hours a night, if not 9. And if I can get 10, I'll take it. So come with me. You don't have to sleep with me, but you can sleep by yourself. So if you want to also be part of sleep as a spiritual practice, do it and leave a comment below. Let me know how you're going to incorporate this information. And of course, if you like this video, subscribe, like it, comment, share it with a friend. And if you'd like more insights and information, sometimes data-driven, sometimes woo-woo, head over to katenorthrup.com, because there are things that I send my email subscribers that I only send to them. Thanks so much for joining, and I'll see you next time.